you doing? This is TVM School with Джай Муста Бой, и мы английскую. How are you? Що скажеш, коли ти зустрінеш якого сину земця? So, let's speak English. А англійська мова Шекспіра та нью-йоркських таксистів. Англійська стане у нагоді вам, бойс і дівчиська.
Hello everyone, it's time for an English lesson. My name is Natalia Ляшко. Let's start. Today we continue talking about literature, books and reading, and of course about stories. Your home task from the previous lesson was to write your own story using the pictures from the Dice application. So, I received a huge amount of emails from you guys. Thank you very much for this. And I would like to mention that there were different stories. There were big stories, like long stories, and the really short ones. The shortest story was like, I can see a flower, a ball, a teddy bear, a man, and a dice. And this is a very nice picture. So thank you very much for this two-sentence story. And actually, this is a very interesting idea using short stories. Let me share some interesting facts with you. So have a look at this story written by Ernest Hemingway. For sale, baby shoes never used. So this story was a part of a bet. He promised to write a story with only 6 words in it. Did he do it? Of course. For sale, 2 words, baby shoes, 2 more words, and never used, 2 more words. It looks like an advertisement, not a story. But you can create a story out of it. And this is the fact. Let's have a look at one more story, the shortest story in the world. And it is written by Frederick Brown. Let's have a look. The last man on earth sat alone in a room. There was a knock at the door. This is a very interesting story. So if you look at the first sentence, the last man on earth. So he was the last person, the only one existing in the world. And he was sitting alone in his room, and suddenly he saw a knock at the door. Who was that? And actually, I like the stories that has got endings like this. And you keep thinking, what is going to be next? What is going to be next? You are just curious. And we keep saying that you are hooked as a reader. So, all these stories are very, very creative. And today we'll talk about creativity as well. So, what is creativity for you? For me, these are amazing ideas, innovative ideas, some innovations. And if we talk about 21st century skills, because you guys are preparing for your own living, very soon you will become adults and you will continue living. Earn money, you will do your job, you will make families, and you will be an employee. So you will work. And the most important skills for an employee in the 21st century is creativity. Also, we talk about communication. It's very important to communicate. Nowadays, we can't live without communication, right? And when we talk about communication, we also talk about collaboration. Collaboration means that we work together. Співпраця. So, communication, collaboration, what is also important for the modern world? Critical thinking, we say. Critical thinking, this is something that we need to solve problems. Вирішувати задачі. Критично мислити. So these are the 3 important skills for the 21st century. But creativity is in the center. This is the most important part. You can't work properly if you're not creative. For example, look at me, I'm a teacher. In order to keep you motivated to study English and to learn, I need to be creative. Let's look at another job. For example, a doctor. Probably a doctor shouldn't be very creative, right? But if we talk about a family doctor who works with little kids, they need to be creative in order to relax the children and help them to calm down and treat them and examine them and analyze them in a peace way, in a calm way, let's say like this. If we take a different job, like probably a writer, an author of the book, Of course, they should be creative. So today our task is to write a book review. And we talked about this in our lessons. Do you remember the lesson with Olga? So we talked about Harry Potter book. And this was not actually the original book review. This was just a short introduction. So let's have a look at it. Let's read together. Harry Potter is an adventure book. It is written by John Rowling. This is a story of a young wizard and his friends who fight against a dark wizard. So, this is just an introduction to a book review, I would say, or a very short one. Let's have a look at the episode where Olga describes her favorite book, Little Women. Enjoy watching with me.
Oh, Little Women, it's a book written, it was written like 100 years ago. It's a classic novel, and it's about four girls, four sisters, four siblings, who are showing four types of characters, mm-hmm. and the author takes us from their childhood to their womanhood, and unfortunately, we lose one character, Bet.
Yes.
But it's a part of Victorian novel, you know? In every Victorian novel, somebody is supposed to die.
Yes, this is just a plot that we are interested in.
And but you can read it, actually.
It's okay, it's okay. It's a very nice
very
book.
Good Christmas read.
So, if we look at this monologue, well, not actually no monologue, but a dialogue between me and Olga, the information that she introduced is like the main information that we need, the most important one, the author of the book, the name of the book, the type of the book, and she described the plot and general recommendations, like this is a very nice book to read at Christmas time. So let's have a look at the book review and the stages and the paragraphs that we need to mention. So have a look. Paragraph one, we need to mention name, type, and author. Let's go. The next paragraph is a plot. Please don't be very detailed. Try to make it as short as possible, but to mention the important information needed and make it juicy and interesting for the readers to read it. When I read the plot, I must be hooked against, like, ooh, I want to read this book. So try to choose a very nice, tricky words that the students or the people that are going to read this review are going to be interested in this story. And the last paragraph, general comments and recommendations. Again, is it worth reading or is it just a waste of time? Or you can mention, when I was reading this story, I can't or I couldn't put it down. That was an amazing story. Let's look at the example. Ordinary Magic. Let's read the text together. So follow me. Ordinary Magic is a fantasy novel about a young girl called Abby. It was written by Kathleen Rubina Broadway and is the first book in the Ordinary Magic series. The story is set in a world where most people can use special powers, but the main character, Abby, isn't like most people. She has no special powers and must learn to survive in a world full of wizards. It's a very funny story. This is a fantastic book with a thrilling plot and likable characters. I would highly recommend it to anyone who enjoys fantasy novels. It's well worth reading. So, if you see from the example, let's analyze. Did we mention all the information from the paragraph? So, number one, do we have the title? The name of the book? Yes, Ordinary Magic. Let's move on. A type of a book? What kind of book is this? Find this information. Bravo, a fantasy novel. What about the author? Exactly, this is Miss Kathleen. What about the plot? Is it long? Is it very detailed? No, but it has got the most important information. So there was a girl called Abby. She lived in the world full of wizards, but he didn't have any special powers. So she had to survive in the world full of magic. I'm interested in reading this story. How did she do that? So, in general comments and recommendations. Let's look at the last paragraph. It is a fantastic book. So this is a general comment. And recommendation, I would highly recommend it to anyone who enjoys fantasy novels. So these are recommendations. One more time, let's have a look at the plan. So paragraph number one, name, type, and author. Paragraph two, plot. and paragraph 3, general comments and recommendations. As I told you from the very beginning that creativity is one of the most important parts, and I'm a very creative teacher, probably if you are watching the lessons with me, you know this for sure. And today I have decided that writing a book review of a book that you have already read is interesting, but what is going to be more interesting for you is to write your own story. So I want you to write a book review of a story that you have written yourself. Just imagine this situation. It's not very easy for a person to imagine the situation. Sometimes we need to find something that inspires us. For example, let me show you this object. So what's this? Natalia, why are you asking silly questions? It's a banana, right? But I would tell you, this is not a banana. This is a very famous picture. Teacher, are you crazy? It's not a picture, it's just a banana. So, I would like to mention that there is a very famous artist called Maurizio Catalan who created a picture from a banana and sellotape. So let me show you how it looks. We need some sellotape. And we attach it to the board. The picture looks like this. This is the original picture of Maurizio Catalan. Actually, he wanted to get some inspiration from a banana. So he has been working for a year and he placed the banana in front of him on the wall and he was staring at the banana and wanted to get some ideas, interesting ideas, for writing a painting, for drawing a painting, for some, let's say, some magic, or to find some creativity and to boost his creativity. For me, this is just a banana. And I'm going to eat it after the lesson. That's it, this is just a snack. I can't get an inspiration from a banana. But he got it. After a year, he decided, why not? This is a very creative piece of art. A banana on the wall. And he sold this picture for $120,000. Can you imagine? Why not? So I'm going to eat it later. So we need some activities to boost our creativity, to become creative. And let me have an experiment with you. So look at the board. What's this? This is not a banana, right? Try to think out of the box, become creative. What's this? This can be moon, this can be a plate, this can be a flower probably, right? This can be a button of a t-shirt, this can be anything, right? Now, let me add something more. So what is it for you now? For me, I can see a plate and a biscuit on a plate. Probably I'm hungry. What else? This can be a piece of chalk. This can be a ball. Whatever, actually. Let me add something more here. These kind of pictures are called doodles. You look at it, it looks like a very simple object, but you start thinking creatively. What's this? So I will give you 30 seconds, look at the picture and try to think, what is it for you? What do you see? 30 seconds. Okay, so probably you can tell me that there is a kid or a boy or a girl wearing a huge hat and holding the hands like this, right? And you look at it from the top. For me, this is a bicycle and a Mexican riding a bicycle. We all see different objects. It depends on our creativity. So, let me help you boosting your creativity before you write your own book review. For this, we need a piece of paper or your notebook and a pen. And we'll use this picture. How many circles or plates or suns can you see? Can you count? This is easy. We see 5 rows and 6 columns. So 6 by 5 is 30, right? Okay, just quickly grab your pen and draw 30 circles, like you see from the picture. I give you 30 seconds for this. You don't need to be accurate. This is not a math lesson, just schematically, like sketching. 30 circles. Okay, so now we have 30 circles ready for an activity. Activity is going to be to boost our creativity. So actually now, for 3 minutes, we are going to draw as many objects as you can, whatever you can, guys, or whatever you want, what comes to your mind, in those circles. So there are 30 circles. You have 3 minutes to fill in as many as you can for 3 minutes. Спробуйте заповнити якомога більше протягом 3 хвилин, okay? So let's start. Thank you. Okay, guys, I have to stop because time is up. So as you see, I have filled only 15 circles, not even 30, but you can continue doing on your own. And this is a very nice activity to boost your creativity. If you look at the pictures that I have here, for example, something very simple like a sun, this is very basic, or for example, like this face, happy face, sad face, surprised face. Again, these are very simple ideas. You can also combine two circles like I did with a bicycle. It all depends on your creativity. We can also boost our creativity using word clouds. Have a look like this. For example, for your story, you can just start with the words. If you can't write a very big story from the very beginning, from the sketch, you can just start from the words that come to your mind, like a sun, a leg, a table, a chair, a student, magic, a wizard. And then when you have the word cloud full of words, you combine them together with the story. And you write sentences, and this is going to be a story for you. So, I do hope that I boosted your creativity a bit. And now I'm going to finish my circles and eat a banana. But your task is to write a book review of your own story. You can send this story to your teacher to be checked. And I hear the bell ringing. It means that we need to stop the lesson. Thank you very much for this fantastic lesson. See you next time. Bye-bye.